We're here in Asia, currently in the Philippines, where treasures and stock in the trillions and quadrillions is said to be kept. Diamonds, gold, platinum, historical boxes and bonds from China, United States, Mexico, Brazil, Peru, and other countries globally, and nearly all the world currencies are stored, held, and hidden in these lands. Since ancient times, including King Solomon's treasures and conquered lands by Japan and China, and as late as World War II, it is documented that much of the world's wealth is held or controlled within Asia. We're about to be taken on a journey where we unveil the ongoing shrouded mysteries and riches of the world that is said will soon change every person's life and impact humanity's global future and prosperity. The world funds and assets are poised to change our destiny because of the uncovering and release of global wealth. Join us next time on TR247.
Yes,
our sister city.
Oh, yeah, there you go.
Very good.
Oh, is that real?
Yep.
I did not know that. I'm here getting ready to get some rest. We've got a long day tomorrow going to some of the tunnels in the mountain, and I'm very concerned. We're frequenting an area with the MLF and the Abu Sayyaf, and just last week two Canadians and an American were kidnapped, and it's very frightening. It's a big concern. So I also got a communication from a friend of mine from the U.S. Embassy that he's gotten information and a communique that there's other kidnappings that are about to happen, and they're concerned as well. And so I just want to let my family know that I love them and that I miss them, and it's been a long, long time that I've been away, and I will be back, and I'm doing this for a purpose, and there's a reason, and it's for our future, our family, and for the world change for everybody. And especially my son Jaden, who has Ewing's sarcoma. It's a cancer, and I've not been able to be with him, and I miss him and think of him often. And I just want him to know that I'll be back with you soon, baby, and that just know I'll be there. Get some rest now. I hope everything goes well tomorrow. This is compelling, dangerous, life-threatening, and hopefully life-changing. I find myself in a unique position as I've been assigned many assets and accounts, claimed tunnels, warehouses, and storage facilities throughout the Philippines, and direct to said asset managers of the Republic of Korea, Thailand, China, Hong Kong, as well as many sources direct to the U.S. Treasury, Chinese Treasury, and the Chinese elders. These are the incredible assets I've uncovered. World record-breaking diamonds, emeralds, and other stones. Black coffin said to hold atomic bomb-grade uranium. Historical boxes and bonds. These claimed early 19th century Chinese farmers, Liberty, and Pacelli's bonds. Treaty of Versailles boxes. With face value of $3 trillion U.S. dollars. The Federal Reserve Note boxes and bonds. Iraqi dinars that is said to be part of the Liberty Loan Program and also to revaluate in the short term. The uncut U.S. dollars. The cut U.S. dollars and other currencies. The gold that has been from all locations around the world, including these, Korean gold and won. also various assets, including platinum. These are just some of the global bank accounts. Currently, I'm appointed to many directorships, including the Miners Association of the Philippines, a Philippines Military Generals Association and Foundation, claimed redemption groups, including multiple trusts, princesses, and princes, working with numerous sovereign countries, and formerly Vice President of the Republic of New Lemuria. There are bank accounts globally in 76 countries claimed to be holding billions, trillions, and quadrillions, and one account, the Infinity account, claiming endless zeros, meaning endless money. This money is claimed to have been released for humanity over 40 years ago for infrastructure, building, housing, health, community, education, transportation, advanced technologies to better the global population's existence. These funds are to be used for the transformation of the entire world, ending poverty, hopelessness, and the sad situation that the majority of the population exists. Which stock in the U.S. has recently become one of the fastest growing? A. Farming. B. Prisons. C. Livestock. It's B. Prisons. It looks like people are becoming a commodity like cattle. The history of the wealth of the world is one of the many confidential top secret documents provided to me describing the original owners of assets and its lineage, also transfers. The M1 brief is a detailed dossier that has been provided from a high military general from the U.S. This dossier describes the wealth from King Solomon, the Illuminati breeding period, the big recall, the plan of the experts, and the final distribution, and the hierarchy according to the charts and plans for distribution for humanity. This is the organizational chart of the system. This is the hijacking of the system by the powers that have controlled the system and held all of the funds from being released. This is the shadow system and the Freemason interaction with the system. King Anthony Santiago Martin.
And this is for all the assets, including the Iraqi dinar and the tunnel assets and the accounts in process.
The Iraqi dinar master list for 4 quadrillion. The certification from the Central Bank of Iraq. The top secret HRH King Anthony Santiago Martin documentation verifying 917 accounts globally. Citibank, USA. China accounts. Serbian accounts and other locations globally, including Tonga. The World Bank and UN verifications. Prince Peter Paul Mokaya.
Momentous day, seriously. This is going to be a true, true blessing.
This is the irrevocable assignment of accounts, including the God account, which is the gold, oil, and deuterium account, and multiple other accounts. Also the assignment of tunnels, including the King David, the King Solomon tunnels, also Lemurian tunnel. This also has the Ark of the Covenant in it, and also other accounts globally. Prince Francis Aquino Diag. This top secret document is a coded message for the World Bank to recognize and activate accounts.
We were the prince of basically the tribes of Mindanao. And actually the whole Philippines is actually holding accounts, assets in gold, assets in diamonds, in bonds, precious stones as well. And so what he is committed to is getting these assets released for the prosperity of all people.
Former Philippines President Ferdinand E. Marcos and family members. Former President Marcos was designated as legal counsel and trustee for the global gold and account owners. The former Philippines president is claimed to still be alive. I'm pictured here with the claimed Ferdinand E. Marcos. Here are certificates, documents detailing some of the 1,000 accounts created by former President Marcos in top 100 banks globally. Melbert Baylong Marcos, one of the many family members. These programs are designed to present the current reality, the past history, to providing an entertaining, educational exposure of many of the imposters, the fakes, ultimately proving the factual and the truth. The Daily Reality Show presents the ongoing attempts to activate global accounts, recovering treasures, uncovering existing syndicates, creating an underworld market for the treasure hunters and the greedy, as well as some sincere people trying to make a change. But many of these people come here, end up broke, jumping out of windows, either shot or poisoned or kidnapped for ransom or kidnapped and killed. There are proven stocks, assets, and treasures within many areas of the Philippines and Asia. I've been educated and have spent years locating and verifying accounts and assets to bring forth for the people. The accounts and the assets are to be monetized with trading platforms and financial groups providing funds released for humanity where the signatories, account owners, or trustees are identified and are in covenant and signed unified mission agreements. The world has been controlled by very few who've only allowed a trickle of the technologies and life-changing advancements for all people to benefit. The mission is for all people to become educated, be healthy, be allowed in provided homes, create community oneness, develop unity in general. On the global stage, economic war rages. The controllers such as the Rothschilds, Rockefellers, J.P. Morgan, who created the existing global system, the central banks, still control the majority of the distribution, movement, and the supply of money and wealth. Thousands of years of history bring us to today's existing system. With our program and series, we will expose the many twists and turns, the treaties, the summits, the dynasties, the clans, the secret societies, religious groups, multinational corporations, governments, and controllers above the visible system who have so far maintained control of the global financial system. We will review what's behind it and what may be to come. The assets, banking accounts, master mother accounts and sub-accounts globally at banks such as United Bank of Switzerland, UBS, Deutsche, Barclays, Hong Kong Shanghai Bank, HSBC, and other top 100 banks globally are holding claimed trillions and quadrillions and more. These funds are to be released for the benefit of humanity. There are thousands of accounts globally, including some that I've been assigned and used multiple sources to verify. Commodities such as diamonds, gold, with proven stocks that I have sent for verification and come back as true gold, platinum, palladium, silver, and nickel babbitt.
We're here in one of the establishments in one of the largest malls in the Philippines, and many of these things that we're going to be seeing happen in many different malls and hotels throughout the Philippines and different countries as well. But we're here with Sister Sotera, who has received a Federal Reserve note box as a gift, as a presentation for her to redeem at some point in time. The face value of this box is $500 million, and there's much interest and other things that have come that the value was said to be much higher than this.
I received the FRN box on June 15, 1991, during the eruption of Mount Pinatubo in Zambales.
The funds controllers, above the systems, there's persons such as Rothschilds, Bank of International Settlements, BIS, the Feds, the Federal Reserve System, the Vatican, World Bank, International Monetary Fund, IMF. Refer to our website, www.globalsystemsinfo.com. Military, current and past generals and commanders of various countries, including many that I've personally met and have ongoing relationships, including the Philippines, Korea, China, and Malaysia. Agencies or groups such as the Knights Templar and associated groups, the CIA, Pravda, MI5, MI6, Mossad, and other agencies. The asset protectors, the activist groups act as protectors in some cases, whereas ISIS, Abu Sayyaf, MLF, MILF, and Al-Qaeda are sometimes considered guardians, and they oversee these assets to ensure that no one takes them or compromises them until the moment that they are to be released. We're here at one of the many sites that are excavations in progress right now to find treasures. There's treasure maps that have been identifying locations. We're going to be using some high technology to find other locations where treasures are hidden, where it actually shows 3D into the ground. But this is one of the locations they've actually identified as having treasure within it, and we're going to take the time and go through and see exactly what's going on. We're traveling in from the schooner, and we're getting ready to take a look at some of the tunnels in this region. I'm here with Wilfredo Tagalog, and he's going to tell us the story of the tunnel that he knows of here and the other tunnels that have been undiscovered by treasure hunters and the Philippine National Army. So, go ahead, Wilfredo.
I've been a treasure hunter for over 30 years, and the Japanese had treasures across the river.
And this is what's left of a ladder going into this deep, deep, deep tunnel with multiple areas throughout it. It's very dangerous. There's been cave-ins in different locations as well. But we're going to go in and take a look where they actually found the gold with our team. Okay? So here we go. I'm going to get in here first. And they're going to follow behind in a few minutes. Yeah, very, very deep.
We're in one of the very hot jungles. We just came from the ocean, going in to take a look at the treasures and into one of the caves. Now what happens is the MPA, MILF, and Abu Sayyaf are throughout this area, and they're looking for Americans and other foreigners that they can kidnap. And so we have to be very cautious of what we do now, but we're gonna go in to take a look at one of the tunnels as we go here. Okay, we are here in the Mindanao province with my great friend. Thank you for having us. Blessing. Okay. Blessing, my friend. So, here we have the J.P. Morgan book showing all of the documents. Yes? The $100,000 gold certificate, 1934. How this came about. Also, John Morgan. And then also goes into looking, just kind of scan through this. I think it showed me some of the other dollars that were associated with it. And then we go to the back, here's the certificates, the old map of the United States, and lastly, this. Also here, he has the J.P. Morgan. Oh, I've got it upside down here. Thank you, my friend. The J.P. Morgan box. And then the Wells Fargo box right here. Huge, very, very heavy, heavy box. 75 million is what the denomination is within it. And again, we're in the province, and this is, he received this from. And you, how did you receive this diamond? And you've had George Gates, you said, has come here and other people to view this diamond, which is very, very large.
It so happened that Mr. Gates is having somebody with hair.
looking for precious metals also.
Yeah, here in, I've heard that.
And
well.
He met my brother-in-law, and that is where.
And so then he had actually come here and committed to purchasing the diamond.
Yeah.
At $1 billion.
He been priced at $1 billion.
Apa daya mong Borgatis?
$1 billion. Mega. That is 200.
Oh, so it was 100 million? He offered how much?
One billion.
1 billion for the stone. And this is the treasure stock that we had talked about, correct, the other day. And it does. And you did have jars?
This is only
you
the beginning.
Oh, is that right? Yeah. And you have many jars, or how many jars? What's behind it?
Hold it, I think. Or let me put it into the top. One here, I've got it held here, and again, it's showing as true diamond.
We're back with Anthony, and you brought in your pearl collection of many, many different assets that he's found. Treasures, correct?
Yes, yes.
Treasures
this
throughout the Philippines. So go ahead.
Palawan.
This is Palawan?
Yes, I have more than three pieces for this. This one already cut, and this one is already have a report from international American gemologist. It's more than 32 million years or something, 150 million years. So you have seen any of that, that is only a sample.
Now, we have that correct.
Kilos.
You have kilos of it.
Yes, yes.
Was this from Buddhas? Was this from heads of Buddhas or some of the other treasure?
Jar.
It was from a jar. Was it an antique, ancient jar?
Yes.
Put these back to where we found them. And then you also have white diamonds.
Yes.
You have every precious stone.
Jade.
Like
so many. Yeah. You have so many.
I'm here at Come Again Island getting ready to meet the team to go look at one of the tunnels and one of the places that are said to have one of the treasures. This is one of the many checkpoints that the military stops you and checks for gold and other assets. Motorcycles, cars, and buses are checked. Extraordinary collectibles and artifacts.